Alrighty, let's go. We are doing case break number two of 2022 Topps Heritage 12 box case break number two. So, here are the teams. We got Brett with the Royals, Dan with the Mariners and Blue Jays, Darren with the Phillies, Weebo with the Tigers, let's go. Grizz with the Red Sox, Cubs, Yankees, Padres, Nationals, Braves, and Rangers. Got a feeling something big's coming out of the Braves spot. Ivy Chen, Pirates. Jeff with the Orioles and the Mets. Jerry with the Twins. Jim with the Dodgers. Josh with the Reds and the Brewers. Wampa with the Indians and the Marlins. Justin with the Diamondbacks, Rockies, and Cardinals. Michael with the A's. Michael Craven with the A's. Michael Knetch with the White Sox. Sorry if I said your name wrong. Noah with the Angels, Ray with the Giants and the Astros, and V-Rack with the Rays. And there we go. Let's get down to it. That thing is a brick house. Mikey, I'm about to do a heritage break. Do you want to do the next one? Cool. It won't be for another 4 hours, but. Yeah. And we got four limited breaks. Not limited either, because we got four of them. Nothing limited about that.
You want me to help you open like the packs or something?
No. It's okay.
You gotta do the front and the backs.
yeah, it's.
At least none of the SPs, like the image variations, are front facing. They're all back.
I know. Thank the Lord. I had a ton of Deshaun Watson stuff on ComC. I bet it's going nuts. I bought a bunch. This is how we do it. It's Friday night. Oh, it is Friday night, actually. Getting down on the west side. Jazz. This is how we do it. Yes. Yeah, Hank. Hank. Oh, look at that. It's the first little card one topper I've gotten. That's cool. Look at that. Wall. Wall of the Heritage. Wonder. Vado.
There's so many cards. Oh my.
Fourth all time in wins for the Dodgers. 185 of them. Chasing Don Sutton with a 26th of his run. And isn't it amazing that if you look back on that injury riddled 2021 season, 355 ERA, the bar that he set, you look at that and say, oh, this guy was off. I mean, that's still 15% better than the average last year. And yet, it was quite a bit, his highest one since his rookie season.
Alrighty, let's get to ripping.
And he doesn't have to be the Kirsch of old to make an impact on this Dodger staff. The reality is, he doesn't have to be. And it is a staff that is probably the biggest question mark at this point, and it's all relative. I mean, you've got Bueller.
It's Friday night. Venue. Let's do this thing. First card, Savvy. Salvador Perez. Salvy. For the Royals. Reed Detmers. Jazz.
Second inning, back at Camelback Ranch, and Clayton Kershaw goes the first one and third, checks the box, his first outing of the spring.
Kim.
Davis, Eric Karros, Kirsten Watson.
That's cool. There we go. So, people that are might not know, the short prints are 401, number 01 or higher. So that's why you'll see me look through all these again at the end after we go through them to see if there's any short prints sneaking in the grass. Venezuela, viva la Venezuela. Love me some Venezuela. Rosso. Gonzalo. Loving you. It's already 4:30 p.m. and I'm just starting the first heritage fight case. Shane Bieber. Cy Young. Kirsch. Sorry. Brandon Marsh was underneath there. That's a good one. Those are the ones we got to go through at the end.
Just stayed up, out over the middle part of the plate. Luciano. young guy, you're obviously looking for some success, and, you know, nothing better.
Close, 400, but not 401. Can't stop loving you.
Sit down the line, you're really just going to watch it go by. So I'll tell you this, when I got over, there were, like, if the throws were erratic from an infielder, and, you know, maybe going into the runner, sorry, dude, you're getting there. Seriously, yeah. Because there is something to be said, it's, you know, you're more important to the ball club on the field. Right? At what point, though, do you reach the point of your career where you're comfortable doing that? Oh, I was probably 3 or 4 years in, although I will say my rookie year, we had a shortstop that made, I don't want to say it was 50-some-odd errors. And it got to a point where we were on, like, 30-something. I'm like, look, this dude, he can get 50, if I, you know, but I'm not sacrificing myself.
These are regular season games, this one.
Out of 73.
No, but again, you know, that was a year we lost 99 ball games.
That's cool. For the Diamondbacks.
Bellinger's there, spots this one, that bright sunshine brings an end to the second. Walkie gets the first one for the day. When it's time for dinner, don't screw up on shrimp.
This is how we do it.
There you go. Montreal Jordan knows how to do almost everything. And it turns out that Jim was a farm insurance company that's been saving people money for nearly 60 years. For a great offer, nearly 60 years of quality coverage, go to Jim.
Tom is back. Tom is back. That dude jumped up on the MLB Top 100 today. What up, Tom?
Solved anything.
where he had to be a Dodger. Dodgers had to find a way to bring him back, and it was great to hear that it was mutual. Chris Taylor said he never saw himself chasing more money.
Wonder.
He was happy at Dodger Blue. Dodgers knew they had to have him. They got him 4 years, $60 million. And a key piece to what they've become. Well, he's so important to what the Dodgers want to do with this lineup, with this, you know, with this ballpark, as far as you can give guys days off, you can move them around, and you're not missing a beat. It's not like
Manny Machado. Mike Moustakas.
Pinch pennies and go to the highest bidder. Well, you know, there's something to be said about comfort, and there's something.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting with the NFL. This offseason's crazy. I don't think I've ever seen an offseason like this.
Excellent pitcher. Was great with the Dodgers and then chased the free agency. And he went and signed with Texas. He got more money, but the career was never the same. And like I said, chase the dollars, and if it's significantly different or life changing, I get it.
There we go.
But you can't put a price on, you know, just being comfortable knowing your surroundings. So it takes the walk, first base runner of the day.
Mike Trout. Nice, Freddie Freeman.
He was in AAA in late August last year, but he came back up in early September, played the outfield for the first time in his life, and hit 360 over the final.
I like that one too, Lou Bob. That is true. Crazy. I think without any big QBs in the draft this year, definitely played in this upcoming draft, definitely played a factor as well. Teams were like, dude, there's no new QBs coming in. Got to go get your QB that you need. Matt Manning for my Tigers. Let's go. That's a nice one. He's a big prospect for us. First rounder out of high school. Very, very high ceiling. I like that one. There we go. So far, this case has been pretty good. Good start. Oh, let's go. That is sweet. By loving you. To 573. Look at that color match. That is filthy. I do love the Chrome Heritage. They are so nice. It's hard to justify it on camera. I bet you this goes for a pretty penny. I know I would pay probably a good amount for that, because that's cool looking. Skill. Nice. Torres. Jackie Robinson Day jersey. Friday night fireworks and of course Taco Tuesday. Taco Tuesday. Last promotion. Bring it the heat with that one, baby. Take that, man. I need it. Bam. Woo. Killing it. Bo Burrows into the game for the Dodgers, making his Bo Burrows. He used to be a Tiger. Well, that sucks. We could have had Walker Buehler instead of Bo Burrows.
Strikes out Adames for a strikeout of a Brewers hitter today, and here is Christian Yelich. And what a great example this is of what you talked about the game crumbling you quickly. Goes for being an MVP, it's a neck and neck MVP candidate with Cody Bellinger in 2019. In the last 2 years, I mean, just a shell of himself.
You know what? And I'll go back to him fouling off a pitch off his leg, breaking his leg. Right, that was the end of the 19 season. He and Bellinger were neck and neck. He's never been the same. And, you know, from the hitting standpoint, your lower half is your foundation.
We fly to Bellinger, to out.
And I'm not saying that, you know, he hasn't regained his strength or he doesn't, but what happens is, you know, when you first come back, you know, you're not feeling 100%. Your mechanics start to change. You favor things, and then you get out of whack. Believe that injury has put him, you know, where he's at now.
Cool beans.
I can't stop loving you. This is how we do it. It's Friday night.
You know, you start to get a little bit left-handed, right? It'll be interesting.
This is how we do it. It's Friday night. Man's game. Announcers are funny. We think of limited day? Yeah. We'll break everything that fills today. We're fairly close on just about everything. 20% off on all breaks. Everything should fill today. Because that's the steal. Considering we always price our breaks really low as it is. All right. JD Martinez. Alrighty, here we go.
Second and third season, I got up there, and there were four pitches. I didn't see any of them. Couldn't pull the trigger. And it was like fastball, curveball, And I didn't swing the bat. And I just turned around. I'm walking back. It was the first time that I was completely overwhelmed and overmatched at the plate. Now, I may have looked overmatched many times in my career, but that, like, I walked away. And what am I doing out here? Did you find it again at any point after that?
Four oh one.
It's humbling. It really is. And it sometimes it's tough to accept. But if everybody deals with it. Rosso, Swatsu swung to right. But Kim Street there put it away too. Well, you had a pretty good run, my man, before K Rock carved you up and in, man. Sent you to the golf course. Two gone in a 2-0 game, top four. Up comes Corey Ray. It'd be fun to have you along.
Ooh, what is this little guy? That's out of 100. My dude, Robbie Ray. I know, good old Robbie. Mr. Cy Young winner. He used to be a Tiger. Mr. Devers. Wonder. Some of the pieces are going to be greater or greater than those individual parts, right? And so while it may not look great right on paper, when you put them all together, Gabe Kapler, I mean, he really grew into his own last year. Man, yeah, they're going to be a problem. Let's put it that way.
Here's Will Smith, one gone in the fourth inning. It's this one here to left. And he's Blake Christian Yelich. Soon he can find it in the sun, and he does. Easy was probably an overstatement given how bright it seems to be today. Two up and two down, and up comes Pollock. We've got the Giants who are going to be a fascinating case. How do they come off 107-win team? The Padres, always exciting these days, although they'll be without Fernando Tatis Jr., will miss the first few months with a broken wrist. Rockies at Chris Bryant. Diamondbacks coming off an awful season. So on the surface, it looks like three teams that will compete. And again, the Rockies, the Diamondbacks. And again, there's still plenty of free agents out there, but look to be the bottom of the pack.
Right, and you know, you go to the Rockies, they've got some decent pitching. Right?
Ernie!
You just never know how they're going to do it.
Ernie Otto. For the Guardians.
Yeah, the rotation is, it's sneaky good. It really is. So they're not going to be a pushover. I can't imagine that Arizona is going to struggle as much as they did last year. I mean, everything just went wrong.
Kind of the opposite angle that we're talking about with the Giants. Right? Nobody thinks the Giants are going to win 107 games again. Nobody thinks the Diamondbacks are going to lose 107.
You know, but because of the, you know, added teams for the postseason, sure you'd like to win your division, but you want to get to the dance. So when you talk about San Diego, sure they're not going to have Tatis for a while, but you figure he's going to be back when it matters most. You know, they did acquire Voit, you know, which you got to remember. He led the American League in home runs a few years ago,
right? In 2020, yeah. Pollock earns the walk, keeps his inning going. There was a time there for like a year and a half stretch. He led the American League in home runs. By the time the Yankees acquired him for nothing from St. Louis Cardinals to the end of that 2020 season, last year ravaged by injuries. But yeah, Padres are going to be good again. Giants, yeah, it's not to say they're not going to be good. They're going to be good again.
can't stop loving you.
Because they had the 106 wins last season. Despite this guy here not being anything like Cody Bellinger, even outside the MVP season, even close to what you expect from him, even if he lost that MVP season out, Bass was banged up for a lot of the year, wasn't himself. Didn't have Freddie Freeman. Granted, he had Corey Seager, but he missed half the regular season with an injury. And he only had 2 months of Trey Turner. So what becomes of that 106-win group that basically trades out Corey Seager for Freddie Freeman and gets Trey Turner for the whole year? And you hope you get a very productive guy right here at the plate. Down on two. You know, that's one of the things, too. Freddie Freeman coming over here. You know, a lot of times when guys sign big deals, they change organizations, there's that pressure, and they're expected to carry the organization. He'll be able to just kind of fit right in. He doesn't even have to do anything.
Cool beans.
What they've done, they're gonna be a pretty big football club. I think this one is Brewers club. You know, and then when you start talking about what these teams can do in a short series, I think the Dodgers are by far and away the most complete team. You get into a short series, it's gonna be a fun postseason.
Bellinger down swinging, and that ends the fourth. To the fifth we go in the opener spring training. 2-0 game in Glendale. When it's time for dinner, don't scrimp up.
All right. This is a marathon. Ooh, we got another red. Oh! Let's go. Wander, red refractor. Bam, 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 bam. That's a biggie. Let's go. That's so cool. I love these red ones. They're to 573. These things are awesome. Second red refractor in this bunch. That is a good.
A lot of that was with Texas, but then he went to
to the KBO to finish off last season. Opposite field base hit. Feliciano is 2-for-2. KBO, that's a Korean baseball. Korean baseball organization, got it.
Ron Mountcastle.
Shoots the ball to the right, had that big double earlier in the game for left center.
Chum. Remember how you said you would do Heritage case breaks all day and be thrilled? I need to summon you, dude. This thing's a marathon. But that card was sweet. Let me show you something right after this. The stack. Oh, let's go. Come on. Most underrated. Him and Jose Ramirez, most underrated baseball players in the league. It's Friday night. Something on the west side. Chum, look at this. Look how sweet these are, if you're still in here. Color match Mike Trout. Think about a white deco pen. Oh, maybe not white, because that's white on white. Or red deco. I know you say don't do red. Actually, your brother said don't do red autos. But, dude, that would be filthy. And then look at that. These things are sweet. I would love to make this set. It would be expensive, but boy, would it be fun. That would be a fun chase. Yeah, it's Friday night. Let's go. Annika Brian Hayes. This is the 673. This case is like has way more stuff than the last case, I feel like. I need more sleeves.
Pitch clock, and it's very effective.
attention. The good thing is that at this point, a lot of guys are going to have played with the pitch clock in the minors. So, you know, there'll be a large chunk of the league that'll be getting used to it. But also be, by now, by next season, a huge group of players that is at least experienced it, right, at the minor league level. What do you think about, here there is talk that they may bring back the runner at second base during the extra innings? I mean, that was originally, so we're not doing that in the discussion.
Felt gimmicky at first, right? Felt gimmicky, but like it had a purpose. As Yelich takes a strike, short 2020 season, it made sense. 2021 coming off of that short season, made sense too. Really interesting, I think, what they're talking about bringing it back. I'm not necessarily a fan of it, but
so why? Like, what?
It just feels gimmicky.
But
right, that's. I mean, to say that they shouldn't do it because they never have, it's the worst.
Yeah,
that's way of reasoning. So, how about you? Where are you at?
I actually like it. I like it from a strategy standpoint, and it gets you thinking. And there's so many different ways to go about it. As far as, are you going to bunt that guy over? Are you just going to swing? Are you going to go with the percentages? Say you score more, or just let them swing. All these sorts of things.
Yelich off the end of the bat in the right center field. That'll dunk in for a base hit. And bring home Feliciano to make it 3-0.
Feliciano!
Two on and two out.
This is how we do it. It's Friday night. Something on the west side. Justin Channels, I need you right now. Anyone in here? Let's do a little roll call. Who's in here? Say my name, say my name. Tell me your name in the chat so I know you're here. Say my name, say my name. Baseball is on, my life is complete. Say my name, say my name. Need to do a little voice message to my wife. Hey, Morks. Morks, question for you. When you are back home, what, in a week or two, whatever day, whatever time that time frame is, you want to go to a spring training game? Question mark? Let's see what she says. Hopefully she says yes. If she says yes, we're gonna go to spring training. Hopefully the Tigers. I get to see my buddies. Maybe take BP, maybe throw a bullpen. Maybe hit in the cage, maybe take some infield. Xander Bogaerts, I think he could win the MVP this year. This dude, he's about to be in the category of most underrated player in the league soon. Him and Devers. Devers could easily be a... Him and Devers could be an MVP this year. They played so well last year. They've been playing well the last couple of years. Say my name, say my name. Oh!
You know, it's interesting because
Cole.
A young player, though, you want results in spring training. You want, you know, look, I want to roll out a spring hit 450, no question.
Wonder!
As a veteran guy, you could care less about the numbers. You just want to feel like I'm comfortable at the plate, I'm seeing the ball well.
You like Jazz? Dude, Jazz has so much swag. Jesus. Acuna! Matata. Say my name, say my name. Is anyone in here? I have no idea. No one's saying a thing. Hans. DJ Stewart. Ooh, that's nice. Cal Rally. He's a good young player for the Seattle Mariners. Machado.
Psychological, right? You know, you spend time down in the cage, you make some adjustments, you know, you go out on the field and hit, you know, the hitting coach will say, oh, great job. good about yourself. Nowadays, I mean, that still applies, but these guys, you know, they're almost like investigators, and they're going to come to you with that and say, look, you're most successful when you go after this pitch in the zone.
Ooh, my wife responded. Let's see what she says. She said she would love to, but she has online school. Marquez, he's a good pitcher. Actually, let's go through these first. Manny Machado and Buster Posey. Let's go. Ronald Acuna, photo image. To the Braves. To the Bravos. Smart pickup for whoever had the Bravos. Let's go.
I mean, you could probably make a pretty good argument that, you know, the best hitting coaches were probably the least successful hitters. I should say at the big league level, right? It just, you know. There's the former Rocky, Tony Walters.
That's sweet.
Not saying the former player doesn't, but that the former player may not specialize in the
Bobichet. Oh, this is nice. O'Neal Cruz. Keep on loving you. Joey Votto Chrome. Ryan Mountcastle. Nice. Devers.
Yeah,
homers in 16, had 30 in that All-Star season. All sure split between the White Sox and Blue Jays. That's a shot up the middle and through. There's one of those where you at least half expect there's going to be a shooter.
Right, like, no, seriously, it's
higher than I would expect it. I don't remember, but do you do shifts early on in spring? I mean, are you just trying to get your feet wet and then you start? Well, it's a little bit of a shift there. It's not a dish.
Yeah, no,
dish. That's illegal. That's a legal one, yeah, right? Legal shift.
Alrighty.
That's a good question. I'm picturing. I'm trying to think. Ballinger coming up there.
We still have a lot of cards to go.
Here's Corey Ray. 0-2 in his first game of the spring. You know, I figured this year it might be different just because guys have only been in camp for 3 or 4 days. And so you would have to spend the first 3 or 4 days going over.
Camera down. All right, there we go. All right, let me move all this.
And the way that it's going to work is that first week of games, which was lost because of the stoppage, the first series gets dropped to the back end of the schedule, Monday through Wednesday, after it was originally.
Let me clean up my desk here. Got a lot of cards everywhere.
Made up in double headers throughout the year. Now, in taking that first series for the Dodgers against the Rockies and putting it at the end of the year, the Dodgers now are going to finish the regular season with a 6-game series at home against Colorado.
Wow. I don't know if I like that, right? Because you kind of feel like they're going to be out of it, Colorado.
Yep.
And you just hope the Dodgers have a big enough lead.
Popped into shallow center field. Ahez coming on to catch it. The Dodgers stay put. Not everybody's going to have that set up where you're playing one team six times, right? And you just team the Dodgers schedule.
Well, and again, Colorado is that team that they have some weapons, right? Marquez. You may face Marquez twice in the last 6 games. Okay, that's not far.
No. And Capella, quietly Mella, right? One of the best guys last year went out. Was it two? Yeah, he started throwing well again, right? He said his own.
Yeah.
So what are they? You said those other games would be partial double headers.
I don't have to miss.
There's never been a better time to get away. With a great deal on the Hyundai you always want. With American best working new cars are driving new. Now's the time to get in and get away. Get you with an EPR for 45% for 90 days on select vehicles.
That's a gold?
Yeah.
Out of a repack pack?
Oh, yeah. Let's go. Dude, that's huge. Last pack. Yes. Joey Votto, the only Reds player left on the team. This is the first one. Gray out of 373. Gosh, these are nice.
Seven home runs and limited time between Toronto and the White Sox. Power
Wonder. Through all those, cool. It's Friday night. Whoa. Ohtani. Photo image for the Angels. This is how we do it. I mean, it's Friday night. Sorry, my wife texted me, got 31 texts.
Yeah.
one gone. Bryce Turang. Federal comes home and induces a soft bouncing ball back to him. Low throw to second, picked nicely, and over the first, not in time. Look at the lead, man.
Look at that. Another one. Photo image variation for Devers.
Yeah, you weren't getting Turang. He can run a little bit. Southern California native. This ball just kind of handcuffs him over it short. That thing just had some ride to it. The Turang was a high pick a few years ago. Really run. That's one of the many great benefits of living in Southern California is just about every team that comes through to play the Dodgers, several guys who have Southern California roots, and you can think back to watching them come up through the area, through the high schools, through the local programs. Stay the Dog stands in here with two gone. Seems like every series there's a mini cheering section of friends and family for the other team. Yeah. Dog, the longtime Rocky.
Star a few years ago, it looked like he was really on the cusp. You know, then he had did he have thoracic outlet or something? I mean, it was some kind of crazy or something.
He had a stress fracture in his ribs.
Okay.
In spring training, and then as he tried to come back from that, his back started to flare up. He had a broken foot at one point. Just a really horrible injury history. A guy who was
Uh-oh. My birth mother is calling me. I'm in trouble. Grizz, you've been on fire on this break. Yeah, photo variations. Oops. I'm loving you. Only thing I want to do. So many cards. So many cards.
just getting good feels, getting your timing down, and making sure everything's you're working on the backfields. It's feeling good in the game setting. So,
Grizz, we have quite a bit of breaks today. This is just the beginning. It just takes forever for these. I'm gonna have to sub Mikey in so I don't go insane in the membrane. Javi, ooh, and they have him in a Tigers uni. Let's go. That was a quick change. Cam, I am not too sure, to be honest with you. I sit down here in Jacksonville, so I'm not sure what we have there. But pretty sure we have like all the new releases there. If they haven't sold out yet, which I don't think they have. So like limited, contenders, anything that's came out recently, and then all the usual stuff. They have a lot of wax there right now. You should go in and check it out, because I know we have, there's been a lot of new releases lately. So I doubt we went through everything there. Oh, yeah. Can't stop loving you. Carlos Correa.
Right.
Garrett Cole. Ooh. All right. This stuff works about hurting your pride. This stuff works early. We are done. Let's do a quick little recap. DJ, Garrett Cole, Carlos Correa, Javi Baez, Devers, Image Variation, look how cool that one is, Otani, that's really cool, Robbie Ray Mini to 100, JD Martinez, Mike Trout, Manny Machado, Zach Gallen to 73. Sally Perez, another Devers. O'Neill Cruz, Jeff McNeil, Cunha Jr., image variation. Herman Marquez. Ryan Hayes. That's to 673. I love these. Mike Trout to 573. Wander to 573. Matt Manning auto for the Tigers. Whit Merrifield. Ryan Mountcastle. Ernie. Rafael Devers. Julio Urias to 373. And Joey Votto. And that is our break. It's Friday night.
He just filled it all out. Then he called both his parents, and they were both screaming on the other end of the phone. Couldn't believe that they were going to be able to go to several games to watch him pitch. If he happened to make the major leagues.
Alrighty, thank you very much. That was number two. And thank you. We'll see ya.